My dear friends, here I am again, this time with a cigar, a little cigar, so I'm not gonna bark like in the other movie. So dear retarded friends, I told in my last, and it was the first movie, that there are even movies where an amputee, a female amputee, her leg is a gun. Here are both, probably. I'm gonna place it afterwards, but here are both. You see a trailer of it. And here you see the name of it. Anyway, I'm Amputee Alex, triple amputee, right above elbow, give me the high five, and double above knee. I don't know what you're gonna see, but I mean, there is nothing here anymore. So I wrote down some little tiny subjects. Let me put the brake on from my wheelchair that I don't roll away. So I wrote down some things. And what I wanted to say is that last time I mentioned that I lived once in USA, big beautiful USA, downtown Fort Lauderdale near Miami, Florida. It was really very nice. I basically went there years ago to visit a wannabe friend. I mentioned him in the first movie, an 81 years old guy. So I went there to visit him, that was in 2007. And then he told me, oh Alex, America needs you, America wants you. Nice idea, because I had anyway not a big family to stay behind in Europe. Anyway, I do not like Europe. Another time I explain you why I don't like Europe. But so I stayed. I married even with a female devotee. Melissa was her name. And Melissa was a real huge drunk. Oh my God. Even when she was without alcohol, she found alcohol. She even drank mouthwash because it contains alcohol. One night, me and my good friend Wayne, we discovered hidden cans of beer everywhere, even in the little compartment below the bed tube. Oh my God. I even want to go on talking about that. But what I liked about Florida is that it was and is complete wheelchair accessible. Yes. If you're not from America, you probably don't know, but there is really only one place on this world where it is completely wheelchair accessible, and that's Florida. I mean, I've never seen this, but everywhere you can enter, everywhere there are bathrooms. Now, let me explain in the meantime why I do not like Europe. Because over here they find history more important, you know. The craziness about Hitler's time, the craziness about the Romans. That's so much important here. Even where I live now, in Portugal, near Lisbon. I mean, over here, little doors and a lot of stairs are priority number one here. Yes. So believe me, I cannot go out without help because I don't have a motorized wheelchair, and also because, I mean, before I lived in Brazil, I lived in Sri Lanka, and in those countries people help you when they see that you need help, they help you. Over here, oh my God, no, they just watch at you, and if you fall, and if you even a car will drive over you, they just walk around. European mentality, it's so stubborn, it's so closed, you know, I mean, it's so fresh, it's cold. It's another reason why I stay out of the cold northern Europe, because I am from beautiful downtown Belgium, the most ridiculous country on this planet, for sure. One of the most smallest, but the most biggest craziness I've ever seen. So I love it to be on 2,000 kilometers away from this tiny little shitty country that I never liked. For many of those reasons. And other reasons I will tell in another movie. So meanwhile, you have seen that little spot about people with a gun leg. Why doesn't this exist in real life? Shoot around with your stump. So, another thing I want to tell about my travels, of course, is I love to joke. I love to provocate. You know, for sure, here in Europe, you have that mentality. They don't watch at you, you know. Only children. All children are always honest. And children, you hear them saying to their parents, "Hey, daddy, why does that guy have no legs?" So when a child asks me that, I answer always, "I was in the movie The Invisible Man." Now, of course, I cannot tell them the truth. Imagine, they will be traumatized, you know. So I tell them I was in the movie The Invisible Man, and that they didn't find the thing to bring me back to visibility, or whatever word it is in English. I speak 5 languages, I mix it up every day. So, but provocation. I like to see the reactions. In Belgium, when people were watching, you feel them watching, I turned my wheelchair and I told them, "I'm here. I realize you don't see this every day. So if you want to make a picture, go." And then you see those faces turning red. Well, not if it's a black person, but when it's a white person, they turn red. And then I go on. And if you want a signature on the picture, it's 5 euro. Bye! And I go on. And they don't say anything. Nothing. But in other countries, I remember I was once in the airport. And I wanted to buy an airplane ticket. That's what you mostly do on airports, buying airplane tickets, not train tickets, not boat tickets, you know, not bus tickets. Well, depends, were you inside or outside. But anyway, inside the airport, I went there to a company and I told you, "Look, I want to have a ticket." "Well, it's, I don't remember, it's about $800 US. And I told them, "I'm gonna pay only $400 US. "Yes, why, sir?" I said, "Well, because I'm health, I'm traveling health." So those people start laughing, but they don't say anything anymore. One time in USA, in Florida, I was at Walmart. I'm making promotion for Walmart. Walmart! The best place to be, big, huge promotions. Anyway, and there in the checkout, the cashier was telling, "Oh, I'm standing here the whole day and I have so many pain in my knees." I told her, "I never have that. Never." And she started to laugh and even run away from... I don't understand why she ran away, but I say those things very seriously, but I'm not very seriously. People that know me know that I'm not seriously. Another time, also in an airport, I think it was even the same airport, there was a shoe cleaner. Yeah, of course, doing the shoes, very cheap, pair, you know, mostly a pair. So I went there and I asked the guy, I say, "How much would you ask to do my shoes?" He was watching. Anyway, I think that's enough for this movie. Thanks for watching. Till next time, don't forget to visit my website here, yeah? And, well, you can email me, of course. Only about serious things, you know, I mean, here. And if you like this movie, click on like. If you dislike it, click on dislike. I really don't care a shit. Okay, give it a high five until next time in the next movie. Bye. See you later. Alligator. Adios. Ciao. Bye.